Welcome students. Before we start our lesson today, let us understand the prerequisites of today's lecture. So by the time we are already aware with the sequential flow of programs where in all the statements are executed in sequence one after the another. After that we had seen the selective flow where we use the statement if, else if, selective set of statements. Now we'll be doing we'll be using iterative control flow. So in this iterative control flow we'll be learning about for loops and while loops. So before we proceed about iterative statement, let us understand what is the meaning of iteration. Iteration means repeating a set of statements execution as many times. So when you have to repeat a statement, you land up in either of the two situations. Situation one, where you know how many times you need to execute a loop, and situation two, where you don't know how many times you need to execute the statement or repeat a statement, but you have a condition where you know ki till the time I reach this condition I have to repeat the statements. So depending upon the situation, we have a for loop and a while loop. Okay, but here, now today we'll study about a for loop. Okay, in the for loop is also called an entry control loop. It is also called a definite or determinable loop and a counting loop. Why so many names have been given to for loop? We'll be watching this in our succeeding slides. So Python for loops are actually a special kind of loops which were used in Pascal or C or C++. It is just like an iterator which iterates, which visits each element of some sequence or some collection object one by one. Okay, so in the Python we know a sequence data type like list, tuple or dictionary or a set. Okay, so all these data types can be iterated using a for loop. For loop is the best choice for iterating over any sequences. Now let us see the dissection of the for loop. Okay, for loop consists of two keywords. Okay, the first keyword is for and a keyword in. It has a punctuation mark colon. Apart from that, it should have an iterable object. An iterable object should have elements. It might be empty set also, but it should be an iterable object. Okay, to iterate over this iterable object, we'll need one iteration variable. So this variable, what it will do? It will have the values of this iterable object one by one. Okay, so this loop will be executed as many times as there are elements in the iterable object. So if there is no element in the iterable object, then this loop will not get executed. What does it mean? It means that as many elements are there in the iterable object, this set of for action block statement, it will be executed as many times. We'll see this in detail in our succeeding slides. Now let us understand the basic syntax of the for loop. We have already seen the different parts of the loop. Now here we can see it can have any number of statements before this for loop, any number of statements after this for loop. And this is our main for loop. This consists of our for loop. So for loop, we are already discussed, for keyword, iteration variable, keyword in, iteration object, punctuation mark colon. So this is the header of the for loop, and this blue box, it is a set of actions. So this set of actions will be repeated as many times as there are iterable, as there are elements in the iterable object. Now here is a sample program, you can correlate it. So this is a fruit list, a sequence data type, for keyword, iteration variable, in, iteration object, and only one statement in the action block. So this is the exact matching of our previous diagram that we had just seen. Right now we'll not in the next slides we'll show how we'll see how the execution will happen, but before that let us visit to our quiz section and answer few questions. So class continues after this reflection point. Okay, so by now after this we'll see how to create a for loop. So create a for loop, first of all we'll need one iterable object, Iterable object in Python, like we should have a list, tuple, set, string, or any iterable object that can be iterated through one by one. So these are the different kinds of example. Like this is a list, this is a list, this is a range function which can generate a sequence of numbers. Apart from that, we'll also need one action block. It might be a single statement or multiple statement. Okay, and if there are no statements is there, then we can use a keyword pass. So pass is a valid statement which doesn't do anything, but it can make our for loop work. So now we have understood what are the things that are required for creating a loop. Now let us understand by this algorithm what are the steps that will be followed, or how this for loop will work. So this for loop, what it will do, first it will check in the iteration object if there is a value, if there is an element in the iterable object. So if there is a value in the iterable object, it will assign that value to the iteration variable and it will perform the set of actions in the action block. So after that, when it has finished the statements execution in the action block, then it will again go to the step number. Then it will again check for existence of next element. So if the next element exists, then it will again perform the set of actions, and this will go on till the time all the elements are the finished. So when the elements are finished, then what will happen? It will go to next statement after the for loop. So this is the basic working of a for loop. Let us understand the same thing by using a flowchart. In the flowchart, you can see it will go to the first element of the iteration object. If the element exists, it will assign that current element to the iteration variable. Action block will be executed and it will go to the next statement, next element. So this iteration will continue till the time element exists in the iteration object. So when all the elements are finished, then it will come out of the for loop and execution of the next statement of the for loop will happen. So now we'll see this theoretical part by using some examples. This example we have already illustrated. Now we'll see the working of this example. So we'll see the working using a Python visualizer. Okay, so in this you can see it will this is the output area. It will show you the output, and here it will show us the different types of variables. So let us see where we have, after the execution of first line, variable fruit list is created. So execution of line number 3 will happen. So what will happen, variable fruit will be assigned the first value from the fruit list and the set of actions block will be executed. So one by one it will take actions, and again this will take the second value is guava. So again this will be executed, and like this for loop will go on executing. So when it will reach the value avocado, after that there are no elements, and the last statement after this for loop will be executed. So this is the working of our for loop. Now the time for quiz number 2. That's all.